Hey guys, welcome back. This is Kanai and today we have something rather special. Some say it is the younger sister of the KTM Duke 390 and Bajaj says it's a totally new bike, but basically this is the new Bajaj Dominar. Now this bike belongs to a friend of mine and I've been riding it only for a few miles, but I've always wanted to do a video about this bike because I used to ride a 390 earlier in comparison. So this bike has been around for over a year. It's not really doing that great in the markets, but you can see Dominars everywhere. A really eye-catching bike. You'll definitely turn around to see one. Now I've been riding this bike for at least 5-6 kilometers by now, and to anyone who says it's like a KTM Duke 390, it is absolutely not. Though this bike shares the same engine as in the block and everything from the KTM, but character-wise this bike is totally different. Now, as you all know, Bajaj is owning quite a lot of stake in KTM and Husqvarna itself. So in the future, I think you should be expecting a lot of similar parts being used, similar technologies being used in Bajaj, Husqvarna and KTM bikes. So is the case with this bike. Like I said, the engine is from this KTM. The belly pan looks similar to the KTM. The sprocket is slightly smaller than the KTM. It shares the same tires you get on a KTM. And the forks, though they look similar, but they are not made by WP. All in all, it's a good bike till date. I'll quickly make a video of all the features and we'll get back to it. Now when you see this bike for the first time, the most striking thing is going to be the design. Instantly you would know that this is not your average Pulsar designed by Bajaj. So it's not got any parts similar to the Bajaj. It does not share the designing cues with the Pulsar NS series. And all in all, it looks like a very decent bike. Next major thing you're going to notice is going to be the headlights. These headlights are fantastic as compared to the Dukes. The KTM has a really shitty headlight with a small, you could say spread area, which makes riding at night very difficult on highways, especially when you have traffic from the other side. These headlights, however, they are LED headlights. I have ridden the bike at night. They work fantastic. Of course, not as good as the Pulsar 220. But much better than what is being offered on the KTM Duke 390. Another important feature for this bike is going to be ABS. Now, it is not the same sensor plate, I think, that is used on the KTM Duke 390. However, it has the same ABS. You get the same vibrate brakings. Now, ABS, I've seen a lot of bikes in this segment have started to offer, but I don't see the point why no one is offering it. When you come to this kind of a power, something above 25 to 30 bhp, it becomes very necessary to have ABS because you'll be accelerating a lot, and considering Indian traffic, you'll be instantly going full power and then someone comes in between, you'd want to start braking. So that is where ABS really comes in handy. As you see, the ABS is on the front tire and the rear tire both. Dual channel ABS. The rear also has vibrate braking system. You get a preload adjustable reservoir shock system in the back. In the front on the KTM you get WP shocks. These shock ups are made by Bajaj, though the shock ups are really thick, so they should be able to give you good damping. The speedometer looks classy. Small strip giving you all the necessary details. You have two buttons on the side here which are used for adjustment. Then you again have a display screen on your fuel tank that gives you battery, oil content, whether ABS is functioning or not. The malfunction light shows up. You also get the backlit switches, traditionally Bajaj feature. The seat is much more comfortable than the KTM. I'll get back to the seating posture in quite a bit. The rear seat is very similar to the KTM. If you sit, try to keep a gap of 3 inches between you and the rider, you are going to sit on the edge of the seat. The tyres are the same ones you are getting on the KTM Duke 200, the MRF FC ones. Wonderful tyres. I've used these on the 390s. Great tyres for that bike as well. Now coming to posture, as you see, you sit much behind on the Dominar as compared to the KTM. In the KTM, you sit exactly somewhere between the bike. So the kind of control and aggressiveness you get is very different. Here, your hands are pretty stretched out. You're sitting behind. Your seat height is practically as similar to as your headlight height, so it's a much more relaxed seating bike as compared to the KTM. Comfortable to ride, I'd say it will be a good long distance bike, and
probably more comfortable than the KTM for sure.
The radiator and oil cooler system looks similar to the KTM.
Probably not a KTM part, but the same vendor making the same product. So Bajaj have used quite a lot of parts from KTM, or at least quite a lot of ideas in trying to make their bike better. Now these are all the good things. I'm going to tell you one major drawback of this bike is going to be the vibrations and the power band. Now KTM really comes to power after 5000 rpm, between 5 to 9000 rpm. This bike on the other side, expect power between 3000 to 6000 rpm, and the moment you go above 4500 to 5000 rpm, you are going to get so many vibrations in your seat. I think that is more because KTM has been in this industry for a long time, so they know the problems created by a high cc single cylinder engine. Bajaj on the other side has given this a first shot. Probably they did not consider the amount of vibrations you'll be getting from a 400cc single cylinder engine. However, it's not something that's a major issue. I had a similar problem on my KTM. There's a very good trick to solve all the vibration problems. If you need any details, I'll put it down in the description below of how to get rid of the vibrations. So that is the only drawback, I would say. At around 1,60,000 rupees, it's a very decent bike to buy. Now on the media, there's been a lot of speculations about whether it is this bike is better than the Royal Enfield or this or that and everything. Now I'm not taking a stance publicly, but personally I do not open show. So is it better than the Royal Enfield? Yes, it is better than the Royal Enfield. Any bike is better than the Royal Enfield. This animal, if you ride it, is better than the Royal Enfield. Okay, so Royal Enfield is a very different thing. So yeah, it is a much better bike than the Royal Enfield. I'm not going to get into why, you know, this is a better bike and how Royal Enfield has got some water history and shit. But speaking practically, I think this will be a way less, expensive on the pocket, much more easy to maintain. If you go on a ride for a Royal Enfield for 150 kilometers, it has to go to the service center next day, like has to, or it has to be picked up from the highway. In this case, that is not the scene. Plus, it is a very good bike for someone who is a matured rider, who's not looking for something very sporty, but powerful enough to do what he wants. The KTM, it's, you know, if both these bikes were girls, the KTM is kind of a bike that would like to go clubbing every day, and this bike would like to go for a candlelight dinner every day. So I think that should give you an idea about this. Now the guy who owns this bike, I'm going to put a link for his Facebook page directly in the description. If you have any doubts, you know, before buying the bike, you'd like to know more details about how this is, how things are working out, the service cost and everything, feel free to directly message him. I'll let him know as well. And if you have any other requirements for on this bike's video, please do let me know. I'll make a video of that as well. And if you want me to make a video about some bike, please put that in the comments as well, and I'll try to get that bike from somewhere, ride it for a few hours and make a video of it. So see you guys, bye, keep rocking.